Hello children, welcome for today's biology class. So today we are going to continue the chapter Living World. Okay, the topics going to be covered are biodiversity and rules for nomenclature. So first let us study what is biodiversity. The numbers and types of organisms you can observe, no, varieties are there all over the world on the earth. So that you call that as biodiversity. The number vary from place to place according to the environmental condition. Some place the biodiversity it may be more. When the conditions are favorable, the plants and the animals living there will be more. So if the conditions are unfavorable, the plants and the animals, organisms present can be less. Like that, the biodiversity, it is known, that is the number and types of organisms so present on earth, that you call that as biodiversity. There should be biodiversity for the survival of organism. If just you imagine only one organism is there, so what will happen? So they won't be getting anything. So for shelter, for food, for everything, one organism depend upon other. So diverse organisms, it helps in the better maintenance of earth. So here they can see, you know, varieties of species of, you know, birds and all, fishes, like that. Everywhere you go, you know, there can be varieties of species all over the world. I told you, know, according to the environment, when the environmental condition is favorable, so there you can see varieties of biodiversity. So here you see the human being, he depends upon plants and animals the same way one animal it depends upon another. Okay, for all the necessity they depend upon. So next one, let us see regarding nomenclature. So here we studied varieties of organisms are there. So while studying all the organisms to be named, so the naming of organisms, no, you call that as nomenclature. So you need some common name because there are different languages are there all over the world. So that's why, so for discussing that, no, regarding the organisms and all, there should be some common language and common name also. So because of that, no, so mainly the Greek word or Latin word, no, mainly the language Latin is used for this purpose. So before naming the organism, you have to identify what type of organism it is, then only you can give the name properly. Okay, so here scientific names, so when you observe, no, it ensues mainly there will be only one name will be the scientific name, and that name will not be used for other organism. For one organism only one name will be there. Here the scientific name, it has two components. First is the generic name and next is the species, the specific name. So here that way you call that as binomial nomenclature. The Carl Linnaeus, he is the scientist, he proposed binomial nomenclature. So in case the word I told you, know, it will be giving some meaning, that is Latin meaning it may give. So in case if they don't, we are not able to use the Latin word, so there we use some word which will be Latinized. For example, Mangifera indica. So here Mangifera, that is for mango. So indica, as it belongs to India, the word is Latinized and we are using the term indica. So Mangifera is the genus and indica is the species here. So here some rules ought to be followed for binomial nomenclature. The scientific names I told you, know, generally the Latin word it is used and it is written in italics. Okay, can you observe Homo sapiens, italics, it is written in italics. When you observe the first word, no, it is genus and the second word is species. So while it is handwritten, it has to be underlined separately. For example, Homo to be underlined separately and sapiens to be underlined separately. When it is printed, it is written in italics. The first word, it is, no, starting with the capital letter and the next one with small letter. Can you see here? So in that way, while writing the names or typing the names, you have to be careful. These are the rules for nomenclature.